You're praying.
Come on.
Anytime you're praying over the offering, yeah. Anytime you come to church, please don't die. But whatever you can do, give God your 100.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank
you. Yeah.
The next reason why he died in church, it was not what he gave, but what he kept back. He came to church. He came to church. Can I see your bag?
No.
Can I see your bag? It's not all the time. Yeah, I just want to see your bag. When he came to church, he had a big bag. Everybody was saying, look at the look at what all he's bringing to church. Look at him. He got a big bag. Mm-hmm. Everybody's in awe.
Come on.
He stands at the altar.
Come on.
With his chest poked out. Mm-hmm. No one.
No.
I got a big bag.
No one. Come on.
But you know what? The problem was, he had a big box, but not so much gifts.
Mm-hmm.
He had a big bag, but nothing's on the inside. Mm-hmm. So on the outside, he appeared to be holy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
On the inside, he had no anointing. On the outside, he would jump and say, God, you did it. But on the inside, there was no anointing. The problem was when God was calling for his all at the altar, he rededicated 80% but kept 20 at home. We die in church. Because when the altar call is given, there's a part of you, you say, God, you can have. But a part of you, you say, God, I like this, and I'm going to keep it for myself.
Come on.
In order for you to get total deliverance, you got to give God all of you.
Yeah.
There's some stuff in your life you hear from God, but you can't hide from God. There's some stuff when it's a living service is in the house, and there's some areas in your life God want to touch, but you keep it private.
Alright.
Let me preach to the people in the balcony.
Come on, Pastor.
The truth be told, not your neighbor but you.
Come on.
Since you've been saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost, and God is still working on you.
Yeah.
There's some areas in your life that's not right, and you like it.
Yeah, come on.